Herring Auto Mom. Back with another one. By popular demand, I shouldn't say that, but basically I just posted, this is my truck, okay? This is the truck that I towed cars with, you know. This is, for all intents and purposes, this is my baby. I've had her for about 4 years now or so. My daughter rode in this truck, you know, a lot of fond memories with this. But I've got some other things going on in the background, and it's time to let her go. So this is a 2002 Chevy Silverado. It's all right. I'm not gonna say it's perfect, you know, but this is my baby. Like I said, got some other things going on, and this truck has to go. So first and foremost, I think it needs injectors. It starts, runs, drives, idles, all that kind of stuff. I'm gonna drive it home tonight, but I think it needs injectors. I'm gonna take you through all the bad, and I'll let you figure out the good. The toolbox and the headache rack, not included in the sale. I'm taking those off. Okay, when I first bought the truck, it had a problem with the fuel sender. The gauge wasn't working, so I took it back to the dealership I bought it from, and so they had to pull the bed off or whatever else. When they did, they stuck the bed on a four-post lift, so now you have a dent there, a dent there. If you don't know that it's there, and you're not looking for it, you may not see it, but I know it's there. Back here, you've got a little dent where the, yeah, into the bumper here. Hitch, there's just this part. I'm taking that with me. The dents on this side are not nearly as bad. They're kind of non-existent, so I won't even worry about that there. The paint is showing its age in some places. Mostly on the hood, you can see that. On the roof, it's about the same. We have a little bit more right here on this door. Up here on this door. Oh, a shirt and a jacket. Like I said, I'm driving this, I'm taking it home. Headliner has seen better days there and there. My rearview mirror, it was really cold the other day. I'm gonna assume that had something to do with it. This sucker came off yesterday, so I've gotta get that back up there. The truck will come with a rearview mirror properly attached. It's got the cloth interior in decent shape. I didn't work it too hard. It's not sweaty, it's not nasty. Bed liner, I forget what they call this. I never used it. Gooseneck fifth wheel, something like that. I don't know, but it's there. Whatever that is. Well, it's the rails for it. I think you still have to buy another attachment for it. Driver's seat, look at that. It's not bad. It's not bad. It's got 206,000 miles. It's diesel. It's 4x4. This is an LB7, Allison transmission, all that kind of stuff. Glow plug light. And there she is in every bit of her glory. So, no weird funky lights. Sometimes the check engine light does throw. When the check engine light comes on, it's a P0087, which I think it said low fuel rail pressure or low fuel pressure or something like that. So I can't say for sure. Low washer fluid. I can't say for sure because it has a lack of power at times. And let me put it this way. If you start it up and it's cold that morning, like really ice cold, and it's Florida, you know, but, you know, cold here, it seems to run better, you know, but as if it's a hot, summer, and maybe it has to do with like the fuel viscosity and, you know, stuff like that. But what I was reading online about the P0087, and you can do your own research, of course. But, you know, some people say, oh, we'll change your fuel filter. One guy said it could be a fuel sensor, a regulator, all kinds of, anyways. But I think personally that it needs injectors. Runs good. Sounds good. All that kind of stuff. But, you know, it does kind of, you know, have a little haze at idle if you're looking at it in the right kind of lighting. And if you really get on it, it'll smoke like hell. It just dumps out black smoke. So, I don't know. I mean, really, it could be anything, I guess. But my guess is injectors, because the truck has 206,000 on it. I bought it at 160 or so, and I've never done injectors. I don't know when they're ever done. I assume they have to have been done at least once, you know, LB7 life, but I have no specifics. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. I had to shut the gate here. So, you know, I do sell cars. I own a little car dealership here in beautiful Tampa Bay, Florida, but this is my personal truck. I bought this from a big dealership years ago, financed it, paid it off, that kind of thing. So this is not really a dealership deal per se. Hold on, there's a guy that, where is he walking to? Sorry, it seemed like this guy was... Anyways, alright. So truck is actually running really good right now. I kind of don't want to mess it up, but like if I tried to get in it right now, then it would probably start to show its true colors. And you know, normally when I drive it home like this, I like to just take it easy so that I can get home the whole way with no hiccups. It's never left me stranded anywhere. It just gets to be annoying, like if it decides that the fuel pressure wants to be low, or you know, whatever the issue is, then it's tough to keep up with traffic, and it gets to be annoying. But I don't know, I guess I'll get into it just for the sake of showing you guys. A lot of good memories with this truck. Oh, I did forget to mention, it needs door panels here. These, you probably can't see that. These pull handles are kind of broke on both sides. Okay, our light will be turning soon. Okay, there's a cop, so I'm gonna put my phone down at least for a second here. And hope he doesn't turn behind me. I think we're in the clear. Okay. So right now I'm trying to get in it. It's smoking. And there's just nothing there to really get into. It's not doing it. You know? It's just not doing it. Again, I'm on the pedal pretty good right now, and it won't go. It just doesn't have it. But if you ease into it, then it's all right. See, if you take it easy, totally cool. But if you try to give it too much, it just won't take it. See, I'm trying to give it right now. It's smoking. Oh, there's the check engine light. Okay, we got it to set. So you see, that's what happens if you try to give it too much. It sets that low fuel pressure or whatever. And it just won't take it. But if you take it easy, it'll take it easy. So I really haven't been driving it. I'm gonna put these windows up. I just wanted you to hear the truck a little bit. I really haven't been driving it much since it started giving me this issue. But this is kind of just to show you also, you know, it's like the truck's not helpless. You know, I really don't know if it needs injectors. It could be one of those simpler things, but I've just got too many irons in the fire, and it's, you know, I don't know if I'll ever get around to doing this, getting this done. A little vibration in the dash. If you can hear that, but I'll be really sad to see it go. I don't know. Anyways, if you want to be the lucky and proud owner of this 2002 Chevy Silverado, then call me, beat me. If you want to reach me, you can call or text me at 813-440-7769. You can find me on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram at Herring Auto Mall. You can come see me in person at 3001 North 34th Street in Tampa, Florida. You can email me, herringautomall@gmail.com. I'm going to set it out for $6,900. $6,900. And I think that's a fair price for this truck and its condition. So, like, right now, I'm trying to give it to her. And it just kind of, you know, it won't take it. It starts kind of surging a bit. I don't know if you could notice that, see that in the video. Now I've eased up on it, but $6,900. And personally, I feel, and actually, you're not going to be able to see it. But like right now, you can see there's a nice little smoke coming out of her in the headlights. I can see that because it's my eyes, but when I put the phone there, all you see is just lights. $6,900 for this thing. And I think I'm, it's like I need to sell it. And I hate to be that guy, right? Because you always see that guy on Facebook, Craigslist. It's like, don't need to sell it. I know what I got, you know, just looking and just testing the waters, whatever it is the hell that people say. I don't want to be that guy, but I kind of am that guy. It's like I wouldn't mind selling it. I would be open to the idea of selling it, but I'm not so desperate that, you know, because people hate, I've got $2,000 cash. Well, a lot of people have $2,000 cash. I don't need $2,000 cash, you know, I don't want to be that guy that's like, I know what I got, no low balls. But seriously, if this truck was running perfectly and, you know, could pull a house down and all that kind of stuff, you know, it's probably worth $10,000. I think $10,000 is fair. I don't get me wrong, I see them more expensive at times. You know, I see them for 12, 13, 15, but 10 is a really reasonable, you know, I want to make a deal price. So that being said, you know, I don't know, 69. Fairly firm. Anyways, call me, beat me if you want to reach me. Herring Auto Mall selling his personal truck. And I'm giving you a test drive right here. I mean, you can still come and test drive if you want. You know, I have nothing against that. But, yeah, anyways. All right, y'all.